This is the one side of the leg, all trimmed off with lace. Opened up, this is what the whole of the salwar looks like. It's just a piece of fabric which is cut, just a square piece of fabric, really. And the way it folds is, this is the fold line. And once folded over, this is what it's going to come out like. So I've just finished off the one leg and I'm going to finish off the other side, but before I do that I'm just going to explain, just in case you didn't understand any of that, that's basically what the first pleat is going to form like. And just on the outside of that, where the lace is, we're going to fold that. And then we're going to fold this so that that pleat falls sort of just on top of that. And then again, that pleat is going to come and just going to fall on top of that. And the next one, and the next one, and so on. Forming the whole of the pleats layered one on top of the other like this. And that's the outside of the salwar, which if I lift that up, that's the sort of effect that you would get, a layered effect on the outside of the and this is the classic dhoti salwar. So away from this, I'm going to do the other side, which is, this is the other side piece. Now I'm going to explain this again, just in case for anyone who didn't understand what I was doing. So I'm just going to repeat myself and I could have laid both of these together and just done the two together, but this is just for the sake of explanation that I'm actually doing this. So you just even this out and you measure under my chalk. So the first fold is a square fold, which is 6 inches like this. So at 6 inches we put a notch, and then we measure 8 inches and we make a marking on the 8 inches, and we continue the 8 inch marking all the way to the crotch area. So 8, 16, 24, 32, and so on. And in total, you should have, I think it's 5 pleats that we end up forming. Now, I am actually just developing a flu, so you would have to bear with me, and I don't know what I've done with my scissor. So on this 8-inch mark, just cut a sort of a half an inch marking so that you know where both the sides of your pleats are going to fall. Again, on each of your 8-inch marks, just put a 1-inch notch, half an inch notch, sorry. Now once you've done that, you take your piece, you can actually do both of these together. I mean, I've chose to do it separately because I wanted to explain to you. We will iron this. First of all, we will iron along here so that it forms a crease line. And then we fold this in half and we put a crease mark over here. Again, we fold it over and put a crease mark there. Again, we fold it over, just evening it out at the top here, and put a crease mark here. And this we continue all the way through to the other side, putting crease marks on all the pieces. Once we've done that, I'm going to show you, this time I will show you how I go about stitching the lace onto the ironed-on markings.